All right, so we are saying let V be an n dimensional vector space and it has this basis I. Okay, we remember the definition of the basis. According to what we say, we say these vectors, they should span V. Secondly, they can be written as what? Linear combination. Okay, then there is also an image. It also has a set of bases, which we are calling V to I. So now, if we transform individual vectors in this one, remember this is a basis vector, right? It has those two properties, linear combination, linear independence, and what? Span. So now, if we start transforming each of these vectors, the image that will be produced will be a linear combination of these. Are we following? Are we following? So now, after we do that, so this is the explanation that we're getting here. So if this is a linear transformation from V1 to W, when we transform all the vectors in V, okay, which has a basis, which is this one, right? When we transform these vectors, what we are going to get is a set of linear combinations, which are getting that. Now, the matrix representation of T, or the matrix representation of the linear transformation, is getting these scalars, which are called what? They are called quotients, according to what we're putting, right? So we're just getting these scalars to form a matrix. So we write them the way they are. So the first row will comprise of these coordinates, just the coordinates. Huh? Second row will comprise of these coordinates, third row, and so on up to the end row. Then later, we will have to
transpose.
See that it is simple. Huh? Anyone who hasn't understood? Who hasn't understood what we are going to be doing here?
So when they give us something like that, we have to span it first and see that if it can span, then we find its linear independence, then that's when we can do that, or just go direct.
What we just have to do, we just be transforming vectors. So you'll be given a basis for the object and the basis for the what? The image. So your job is to transform each of the bases of the object and write that as a linear combination of the basis of the what? Of the image. You don't figure. So you'll be given a basis for the object. You need to identify which of these is the basis of the object, but it's very identifiable. Okay? You'll be given a basis for the object and the basis for the image. Okay? And your job is just to transform each of the vectors in the basis for the what? For the object, then do what?
Transpose.
Huh?
Transpose.
Before you transpose, no problem. You write them as a linear combination of this. The instructions are here. So you transform this vector. Actually, these will be numbers. They'll be in numbers. So that's the good part. So you'll be getting more like a number here. Okay? You get more like a number. So here there will be a number here. Okay? And your job, these will be more like equations. Or let me say there will be equations, right? And your work will just be solving these simultaneous equations, which you know how to do from grade 7. Everything. So let's look at an example. Alright, so time is not with us to add in the palace, right? Let's listen. So let's listen. Let's listen, right? So the question is asking us to find the matrix representation of a linear transformation from which dimension?
Three.
Okay, so in this question, whenever we have a three-dimensional space, that is being changed into a two-dimensional space. Okay? And this transformation is defined by this. Okay? Now, we have two bases here. Okay? We need to identify which basis is the basis for the image and which basis is the basis for what? So from observation, which basis can be the basis for the object?
B1,
right? Why B1? Does the same dimensions as Z. You see that? Huh? So always the basis of the object will have the same dimensions as the object. And the basis of the image will have the same dimensions as the what? As the image. So now, from our definition, what did we say we have to do for us to find the matrix representation of the linear transformation? How are we going to do that? What did we say we have to do? We are going to write this, the transformation of this, as a linear combination of what? So we'll say transformation of U1 should be equal to what?
Alpha 1?
U1.
V1?
Plus
alpha 2.
V2.
1. Equation 2, what are we having? Transformation of what?
U2
is equal to? Okay. What else do we have?
U3
is equal to? So now, let's say TU1, what is U1? What is U1? Okay. When we transform this, what are we having? According to the definition, when we transform, the first ordinate is 2 times x plus 3 times y minus what? This is x, y, and this is. So we are saying 2 times what? 2 times? Plus 3 times 1, minus 0, comma 4 times 1, minus?
Plus
2z. 2z.
2z.
Okay, when we simplify this, what are we having? This is 5, comma?
5, comma 3.
Are you sure it's
3?
5.
Are you sure? This is 4 times 1?
Zero.
Now let's do the same for TU2 and TU3. I want just the digits. So what would TU2 be equal to? I want the digits. So this is TU1, which gave us this. So individually do this first. So TU3 is 5.8. How's I need to go up, sir? Are you sure? Where's the person? The second one?
6.11.
Where else I can get up, Sanapo?